The beginning of a new organism. Yes, it is fertilization. And we will now go into detail about its molecular aspects and biochemical aspects. Fertilization. It is where the sperm and the egg, which we collectively call as gametes, fuse together to begin the creation of a new individual whose genome is derived from both parents. And it accomplishes the two separate ends. The first one is sex, where the combination of genes derived from two parents happens. And the next one is the reproduction, where the generation of a new organism begins. And what is the function of fertilization? It is to transmit genes from parents to offspring, and the second is to initiate the egg cytoplasm and those reactions that permit the development to proceed. How does the recognition of the sperm and the egg takes place? And its interaction of sperm and egg, it accomplishes five basic steps. The first one is the chemo attraction of the sperm to the egg by soluble molecules secreted by the egg. And the next one is the exocytosis of sperm acrosomal vesicles to release its enzymes, followed by the binding of the sperm to the extracellular matrix of the egg and the passage of the sperm through this extracellular membrane, and finally the fusion of the egg and sperm cell membranes happens. And how external fertilization in sea urchins takes place? Both the egg and sperm are released into the aquatic environment. Then, how can sperm and eggs meet in such a dilute concentration? And how can sperm be prevented from attempting to fertilize eggs of another species? There are two major mechanisms to solve these problems. They are species-specific sperm attraction and species-specific sperm activation. And how the sperm attraction takes place at a distance? The sperms are attracted towards the egg of their own species by chemotaxis, that is, by means of chemical attraction. And the mechanisms of these chemotaxis differ among species, and the chemotactic molecules are different even in closely related species. For example, in sea urchins, especially in Arabaxia punctulata, there is a 14 amino acid peptide called RESAT, which has been isolated from this seed egg jelly. And this RESAT diffuses readily from the egg jelly into the seawater and recognizes its own sperm and egg if they both are 50 micrometer apart. And when the extracellular side of the receptor binds with RESAT, it activates the guanylyl cyclase activity in the cytoplasmic side of the receptor, and this causes the sperm cell membrane to make more and more cyclic GMPs, a compound that activates the calcium channel, allowing the influx of calcium from the seawater into the sperm cell. And in addition to its function as a sperm attracting peptide, it also acts as a sperm activating peptide. And after all this, the sperm can swim towards the egg. The next one is the acrosome reaction. A second interaction between sperm and the egg jelly results in acrosome reaction. And in most marine invertebrates, the acrosome reaction has two components. The first one is the fusion of the acrosomal vesicles with the sperm cell membrane, that is, where the exocytosis results in the release of the contents in the acrosomal vesicles. And next one is the extension of the acrosomal process. See here, the first one is the fusion of the acrosomal vesicle with the sperm cell membrane, resulting in the exocytosis of its contents. And the second part, it is the extension of this acrosomal process. This picture reveals the summary of events leading to the fusion of the egg and sperm cell membranes in sea urchin fertilization, which is external. Look at the first step. The sperm is chemotactically attracted and activated towards the egg. And second and the third pictures, it contact with the egg jelly and triggers the acrosome reaction, allowing the acrosomal process to form and release its proteolytic enzymes. And fourth one, it is the sperm, where sperm adheres to the vitelline envelope and lyses a hole in it. And the last step, it is this where the sperm adheres to the egg cell membrane and fuses with it, and the sperm pronucleus can now enter the egg cytoplasm through the acrosomal process. The acrosome reaction in sea urchins, it is initiated by the contact of the sperm with the egg jelly, and this contact causes exocytosis of the sperm's acrosomal vesicle and also the proteolytic enzymes and proteasomes. What is proteasomes? It is the protein digesting complexes that digest a path through the egg jelly pore to the egg surface. And once the sperm reaches the egg surface, this acrosomal process adheres to the vitelline envelope and tethers the sperm to the egg. And proteasomes from the acrosome code the acrosomal process, allowing it to digest the vitelline envelope at the point of attachment and proceed towards the egg. And this picture shows the acrosome reaction in sea urchin sperm. The portion of the acrosome membrane lying just directly beneath the sperm cell membrane, it fuses with the cell membrane to release the contents of the acrosome vesicles. And later, the actin molecules assemble to produce microfilaments extending along the acrosomal process outwards. And next is the fusion of the egg and the sperm cell membranes. Once the sperm has traveled to the egg and undergone the acrosome reaction, the fusion of the sperm cell membrane with the cell membrane of the egg can begin. And the sperm egg fusion, it appears to cause the polymerization of the actin in the egg to form a fertilization pore. And the actin from the gametes forms a connection that widens the cytoplasmic bridge between the egg and the sperm, and the sperm nucleus and the tail can pass through this bridge. And in sea urchin, all the regions of the egg cell membrane are capable of fusing with the sperm. But in several other species, certain regions of the sperm are specialized for sperm recognition and fusion. And this fusion is mediated by specific proteins called fusogenic proteins. And in sea urchin sperm, binding, it plays as a second role as a fusogenic protein. See this blue dots, is the binding on the acrosomal process. And this diagram, it shows the agglutination of degelate eggs by binding in different species. Next is polyspermy, means the entrance of multiple sperms. And in sea urchins, it has two mechanisms to avoid polyspermy. One is a fast reaction, which is accomplished by an electric change in the egg cell membrane, and the next one is slow reaction, which is caused by the exocytosis of cortical granules. And what is fast block to polyspermy? The fast block to polyspermy is achieved by changing the electric potential of the egg cell membrane. This membrane provides a selective barrier between the egg cytoplasm and the outside environment so that the iron concentration within the egg differ greatly from those of its surroundings, especially Na plus and K plus ions. Seawater, as we all know, it has high concentrations of Na plus ions, whereas the egg cytoplasm, it contains relatively little Na plus ions. And the reverse is in the case with potassium ions. And these concentration differences are maintained by the cell membrane, which steadfastly inhibits the entry of Na plus ions into the oocyte and prevents the K+ from leaking out into the environment. And the resting membrane potential, it is normally minus 70 millivolt, because inside of the cell it is negatively charged with respect to the exterior. And within 1 to 3 seconds after the binding of the first sperm, the membrane potential shifts to a positive level. That is, it may change from minus 70 to plus 20 millivolt. This change is caused by small influx of Na+ ions into the egg. Although the sperm can fuse with the membranes having a resting potential of minus 70 volt, they cannot fuse with membranes having a positive resting potential, so that no more sperms can fuse with the egg. This is what it is happening in fast blocked polysperm. And the next one is the slow blocked polysperm. The fast blocked polyspermy, which we have already discussed, was very transient, since the membrane potential of the sea urchin remains positive only for about a minute. And this 1 minute, which is very a brief potential period, it is not sufficient to prevent polyspermy permanently. And polyspermy can still occur if the sperm bound to the vitelline envelope are not removed. And how the sperms are removed? It is accomplished by cortical granule reaction, which is a slower mechanism to block polyspermy that becomes active about a minute after the first successful sperm egg fusion. And this reaction is also known as the slow block to polyspermy. It's found in sea urchins and most of the mammals. See, directly beneath the egg, sea urchin egg cell membrane, there are about 15,000 cortical granules, each of about 1 micrometer in diameter. Upon sperm entry, these cortical granules fuse with the egg cell membrane and release their contents into the space between the egg cell membrane and the fibrous mat of the vitelline envelope proteins. See, the picture shows the cortical granule exocytosis and formation of the sea urchin fertilization envelope. This thick and blue line, it depicts the fertilization envelope. And these both diagrams, it shows the cortical reaction in, which is responsible for the slow block to polysperm. See, there are several proteins that are released by the cortical granule exocytosis. One of such protein is a trypsin-like protease called cortical granule serine protease. And the function of this enzyme is to cleave the protein pores that connects the vitelline envelope to the cell membrane, so that it can clip off the binding receptors where the sperms bind. As long as there are no binding receptors, no more sperms can bind to the egg. The next two slides, it shows the events of sea urchin fertilization, that is the approximate time after post insemination. That is, it shows the time schedule between each event during the late responses and the early responses. And this diagram depicts what it happens during the fertilization or fusion of the sea urchin sperm with the egg cell membrane. Here, the binding receptor, it activates the cyclic G protein coupled receptors on the egg cell membrane, which activates a tyrosine kinase from the SRC family. And activation of this tyrosine kinase, which in turn activates the enzyme phospholipase C on the cytoplasmic side of the egg cell membrane. And this phospholipase C activates PIP2, which is phosphatidyl inositol diphosphate, which splits into phosphatidyl inositol triphosphate, or IP3, inositol triphosphates. And this inositol triphosphate binds with the inositol triphosphate receptor on the endoplasmic reticulum surface membrane. and this results in the opening of the calcium channels or calcium ion channels through which the stored calcium reserves in the endoplasmic reticulum opens into the cytoplasmic side of the egg. And here, this phosphatidyl inositol diphosphate here, it activates the phospholipase C in the cytoplasmic side and splits into IP3 and DAG. This DAG or diacylglycerol, it causes the activation of the Na plus or H plus pumps and result in the entry of Na plus ions from outside into the cytoplasmic side. As the Na plus ions inside the cytoplasmic side increases, it results in alkalinity and causes or promotes cortical granule exocytosis and stimulation of cell cycle division, DNA synthesis, RNA translation, and results in activation of the egg. And this slide, it shows the postulated pathway of egg activation in sea urchin. See the first step. The first step is the binding of the sperm or the fusion of the egg cell membrane with the sperm. It results in the Na plus influx, result in the membrane potential change, causing a fast block to polysperm. And next is, after the fast block, by kinase stimulation, it activates the phospholipase C, resulting in the production of IP3 and diacylglycerol. This IP3 production causes calcium release, resulting in cortical granule exocytosis, and finally in slow block to polyspermy and the formation of hyaline layer. This calcium release also activates the NAD plus kinase and converts it into NAD plus to NADP plus, resulting in membrane biosynthesis. This calcium release also results in the degradation of cyclic and inactivation of MAP kinase, leading to the restoration of mitotic cell cycles. And this diacylglycerol, it causes the protein kinase C activation, resulting in the activation of Na plus H plus pumps, causing the increase in intracellular pH by the entry of Na plus ions. This increase in intracellular pH also results in stimulation of protein synthesis, DNA replication, and cytoplasmic movements of morphogenetic material. And next, it shows a possible model for egg activation by the influx of calcium ions. See the sperm contact and fusion, after which it activates the cytoplasmic G protein coupled receptors, that is, it activates the G protein, resulting in the activation of SRC family, resulting in activation of phospholipase C gamma, which in turn activates phosphatidyl inositol diphosphate into inositol triphosphates and diacylglycerols, and both together causes the calcium release, and as the concentration of calcium inside the inside increases, it results in cortical granule exocytosis, leading to slow block to polyspermy, and it also leads to the inactivation of MAP kinase, which results in the reinitiation of cell cycle. And this is how the sea urchin egg and sperm membrane meets and how it causes the activation of the egg. Thank you.